Hi, first grade. In this video, I'm just going to explain to you your directions for your independent practice that you have to do today. It's a wrap-up of everything we've done this week with subtraction. It's just a little review to make sure that you have those concepts so that next week we can begin a new section. Okay? You may want to have with you, or I think you probably will want to have because it's what we worked with all week, your math work mat number 2 and your baggie of cubes to help you with these problems, your counting tape, and you may want to have your dry erase board, dry erase marker, and a tissue to wipe your board. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look right now at the pages you are going to do. You are going to complete page 39. This is out of that independent practice pages bag from quarter 1. And on page 39, you are solving these 3 problems, subtracting using the counting back method, okay? So starting at your greater number, counting back however many you are subtracting, writing your answer on the line. And that's what you'll do for number 1, number 2, and number 3. You can either use the counting tape that they have on there for you, or you can use your counting tape. It's totally up to you. Okay, for page 41, so we're skipping around a couple pages. So you'll see we're not doing 40. We're doing page 39, and then we're skipping to 41, okay? For number 6, 7, 8, and 9, you are using that method where you decompose into a 10 and however many ones there are in that number, okay? And then remember, you put those numbers, the 10 and however many ones, in your math work mat number 2. So 10s and however many ones down here, okay? Then you subtract this number from your 10s, okay? And then whatever you are left with in your 2 tens frames is what you add together, and that's your answer, okay? So that's what you are doing for 6, 7, 8, and 9, is using that method of decomposing your whole into a 10 and ones, and then doing all those steps that I just went through and we've gone through with each other a couple times. So if you do not remember how to complete this, I would go back to that video that was posted, I believe it was Tuesday, where we went through how we do these problems. Go back and watch maybe a problem and do it with me to just refresh your memory, okay? That is page 41. And then the last page you are going to do is page 42. So what you are doing is solving your problem and then creating a fact family. So you'll see for the first one, they've already given you the 2 parts, 9 and 6. So all you need to do is add 9 plus 6 together using whatever strategy works best for you. Put your whole in the whole section of your number bond. Put your whole right here. And then write your 2 addition, or you would just have to write actually your 1 addition. So your 1 addition and 2 subtraction number sentences, remembering that when you add, it's part plus part equals whole. And when you subtract, it's whole minus part equals the other part. And then just remembering that for that second problem, you just flip the order of the 2 parts, okay? For number 11, they give you your whole, but they do not give you the 2 parts. But you currently see they give you a hint that one of the parts is 9. So the 2 parts are the glasses that are empty and the glasses that are full. So the amount of glasses that are empty goes here, the amount of glasses that are full goes here, and then you have all the information that you need to create your fact family. So completing your subtraction number sentence here, writing your other subtraction number sentence, remembering whole minus part equals the other part, and then your 2 addition number sentences, thinking part plus part equals whole, and then that turnaround fact, okay? And what you guys could do is put page number 39 and 41 next to each other and take a picture. I'll have you guys do that side-by-side picture so it's less post to post. And then you can do just page 42 by itself, okay? So again, I'll have this on portfolio. It is pages 39, 41, and 42 out of that independent practice math pages bag from quarter 1, okay? All right, I'm looking forward to seeing your awesome work, and I hope you have a great day. Bye, first grade.